Previously on Game of Thrones.
You'd help the Second Sons, guide them into Meereen.
I can't, Asha.
This could be our only chance.
Get them into the city, help them liberate Meereen, and I will see that you are rewarded.
You think you can reason with a wildling?
No, I'm a friend.
Don't move.
This is my sister, Sylvie.
I have to get in there, Sarah. Lord Whitehill is up to something. He's conspiring against my family, and someone in there is helping him.
Andros is hiring sellswords. Hundreds of them.
What?
He's building an army for Lord Whitehill, big enough to march against Ironwrath.
I want you to keep an eye on everyone. You never know who you can trust.
I'll do my best.
Rodri!
I'm told you're a man who can't be broken.
I've decided to come see for myself. I was just telling your sister. Father's been looking to make a match for me. And Talia's been such good company. Think she likes me? Or maybe your mother? A flower plucked is still a flower. Just dies more quickly.
We could be a family, Lord Forrester. You'd like that, wouldn't you?
Your mother may need some convincing.
You killed our brother!
I've killed many brothers. Sisters, too. But let's put our happy day to the side for a moment. Walk with me. Oh. You won't need your sword. Not where we're going.
I'm not going without my sword.
I'm afraid you are. Here, I'll help you. There. Doesn't that feel better? Oh. You're coming too.
This is Lord's business, not a child's.
I say she comes. I don't trust her with my men.
How fares your father, Lord Bolton?
Better than yours. Polite of you to ask. I loved playing in the woods when I was your age. Still do? So many places to hide. I've gotten very good at finding people.
Roderick?
It's all right, Talia.
That reminds me. Where's Griff? I expected to be greeted by him on my arrival. Bit of a disappointment to have to show myself in. And here I had such high hopes for Ludson.
Griff and his men are under guard. They have no place here.
They do if I say they do. Oh, I really hoped things might be different with you. I hoped we could be friends. After all, I was generous. I've allowed you to keep half your forest. Your livelihood. Yet you went behind my back and called in the Glenmores. I'm not sure how you managed that. The Glenmores have sworn their loyalty to my father.
The Glenmores came to us. We never asked for their help.
Oh?
Perhaps I need to have a word with Lord Glenmore. Well, I'm certainly glad we've sorted this out. Thank you for being so forthcoming. But there's still a price. Ah. Here we are.
Arthur!
Roderick!
You disobeyed me. You disrespected me. Someone has to pay! You didn't think it would be you, did you? Your damaged goods. Someone else's leftovers.
Our sister has influence in King's Landing. She'll hear of this.
King's Landing is very far away.
No!
Stop!
Look at what you've done. I hope it was worth it.
Is it worth it, Arthur?
Please, stop! Please!
Talia, don't look away.
No!
It's very important you see what comes of disobedience.
Roderick, make him stop! Please, do something!
Talia, don't look!
Please.
Look at him, Talia. See what your brother's done.
Please, Lord Ramsay.
Sorry, but they'll never learn otherwise.
Mercy, have mercy! Mercy, my lord!
Did Roderick show mercy to Griff? This is his fault. That's a lot of blood.
You're right. This is my fault.
I told you, Talia. The poor lad's fainted. Let's give him a minute. You want to kill me, don't you?
Release him.
Go on. Prove how strong you are. Do it for Ethan.
No, Roderick. He's toying with you.
Do it. Come on, Roderick. I'm impressed.
Woo.
Lucky for me, you're a cripple. I may have misjudged you, Roderick. I came here to kill you, but now I'm thinking it might be far more entertaining to watch you and Lud tear each other to pieces. I never want to come back to this fucking shitstain of a holdfast. I have better things to do than to play wet nurse to you and Lud. So you'll settle this on your own. Last house standing wins. Otherwise I'll kill you both and be done with it.
There's no need for war. Lud and I have already come to terms.
I've just given you the terms. They're not negotiable. One house left standing.
Yours?
Or Lud's? And one more thing. Can't leave a job half finished. Ready the horses. Not sure you'll have much luck finding other allies.
Thank you. Only a monster would do such a thing. The Boltons will pay for this. Innocent blood shed on Forrester lands. What would Father think?
After all we've been through, must the gods continue to shit on this house? What have we ever done to them? Follow the Starks? Obey the rule of law?
Ramsay Snow is a bloody savage. He shames the entire North.
Yet we're bound by law to obey him. Can't believe it's fucking come to this! The Glenmore Guard are gone. Ordered home by Ramsay. So much for having allies.
Ramsay says he's not taking sides anymore. He means to let the strongest house survive.
I intend that to be us, Roiland.
You'll get no argument from me. But how do we bloody fight them? We just don't have the numbers. Not yet, anyway. And they still have Ryan.
Right now, everything depends on Asher. Once he and Malcolm bring us more fighting men, then
where is he? Where is my brother?
My lady. My lady.
Let me through!
Elena.
Roderick, tell me where he... Oh! No! No! Oh, no! No! Arthur, no! Arthur! It's my fault. I brought him into this. I asked him to help. He did this for me.
You can't blame yourself, Elena. He was a grown man. He made his own choices.
But he trusted me. He always has. I was there the day he learned to hold a bow. He was so nervous, the father called him Quiver. And now to die, like this, tortured, mutilated.
Ramsay Snow did this, he's a madman.
Ramsay was here because of you, Roderick. If we hadn't been your allies,
Elena.
I'm sorry. Oh, God.
Let's get you someplace warm.
How do I do this, Roderick? How do I keep going? Where do I find the strength?
Know that we'll have our justice someday.
Justice won't bring my brother back. You've been such a friend to me, Roderick. Right from the very beginning. I should try to get some sleep. I'm not sure I'll be able to. But I don't know what else to do.
You're not alone, Elena. I'm here for you, whatever you need.
Thank you, Roderick.
Ah, there you are. I haven't seen you since the coronation feast. How many ships do you suppose it takes to move an army?
Ships? Why in the world would you...
Never mind. Mira, I'll be honest. I took an enormous risk.
defying Margaery to get you into that feast. And you thank me by making a scene with Lord Andros, in front of everybody. Margaery saw, of course, and she knew exactly how you got there.
Lord Andros is a threat to my family. He's plotting against them even as we speak.
I believe you, but you called attention to yourself, Mira. And you angered Margaery. Which is why it's not safe for me to be around you anymore.
What?
Mira, you're not the girl I knew at Highgarden. She'd never be so reckless. And now that Garibald and I are discussing marriage, I just can't risk being associated with you. Not anymore. You know how much I need this marriage. I won't do anything to jeopardize it.
Sarah, you can't mean this. I have too few friends in King's Landing as it is.
I'm sorry. I really am. But I just can't anymore. Was it worth it, at least? Sacrificing so much for your family.
They're still in very grave danger, I'm afraid.
Well, I know you'll do everything in your power to protect them. Better go before she sees me. She'll be.
Mira Forrester!
Can I help you?
You need to come with me. Now.
Why would I?
Don't make this difficult.
Come on, Beska, listen. How can you still be angry at me?
Is that a joke? I had Dezozaraza in my hand and you made me let him go.
You know why.
Yeah, you were afraid of disobeying the pretty little queen. You chose your prize over my one chance of revenge.
And for what?
Enough! Your revenge would have cost me everything.
It'd be worth it to see him dead.
Oh, and you'd explain that to my family's corpses.
We should never have come here.
This city. It only holds pain for me, Asha. I was hoping to bury it all with Dezor's corpse, but you denied me that.
I...
Please, I don't want to talk about it again.
Asha, you're back.
Uncle. Let's collect our second sons and get out of here.
If you did as you were told, Daenerys should deliver.
Daenerys, huh? First names with the Queen now, are we?
Your Grace, my nephew has returned from his mission.
It seems you played your part in the taking of Meereen, Asha Forrester. Did you run into any trouble? Reports from the battle are muddled. Perhaps you can clear them up. Well, my time is short.
Nothing out of the ordinary, Your Grace. We fulfilled your orders.
To the letter, if reports are true. I hear you know how to follow orders, despite your friend's efforts to make you stray. You told me Asher was a man of integrity, Malcolm. Now I know you were telling the truth. You have proved yourself an honorable warrior. You have my gratitude. Unfortunately, I cannot spare my second sons.
What?
But Your Grace, the mission was a success.
I need every soldier to hold Meereen.
This is why you denied me my revenge? What did I tell you? She was never going to help us.
You promised me Croft and his second sons.
Which is why I'm not going to let you leave here empty-handed. In truth, we are not so different. We're both far from home. We've both suffered the loss of those we've loved. And we both struggle to do what's right.
You said something about not leaving empty-handed?
Don't make me change my mind. I cannot give you my cell swords, but I will give you the next best thing. This gold will be of use. Perhaps you can find the swords you need in Marine.
Thank you, Your Grace.
We promise to put it to good use.
I'm sure you will. A new day is born in Marine. The slaves have thrown off their collars. There are fighters among those who used to be bound.
On behalf of the Foresters and the Branfields, I thank you.
See that you are ready when I return to Westeros. I have other plans for you, Malcolm.
Plans for me, Your Grace?
Plans that will help House Forrester, I hope.
I would like you to stay and serve me. I have a task for you.
Your Grace, I am humbled. But I owe my allegiance to my family.
And they will be grateful for the Targaryen alliance you've helped forge.
I am honored you would ask me. Might I discuss it with my nephew first?
Do so. But let me know your answer soon.
You'd seriously consider staying in Essos?
I'm not sure. This is all rather sudden. If she does come to Westeros, we'd want Daenerys Targaryen on our side. You've made a good start with her. I could strengthen that bond. It's worth thinking about, you have to admit.
You're right, Uncle. The Mother of Dragons would make a powerful ally.
If she succeeds in taking the Iron Throne, she'll be the only ally we need. But whatever comes of this, we still need men who will fight for us now. The Queen thought we might find them here, among the newly freed.
Little Queen is right. Marine holds plenty of killers, and I know the worst.
So what are we waiting for? Let's go get them.
I don't know, Asher. They're not like us. To them, killing is a sport. It's fun.
Let them have fun with the White Hills, then. As long as they kill them, I don't care.
Don't say I didn't warn you.
I must talk further with the Queen. Don't get yourselves killed.
So, where exactly are we going?
Now, these fighters used to be slaves. If I had to guess, I'd say they'll be trying to live like masters.
You're freezing.
Yeah, don't worry about it. Someone has to keep watch. Oh.
It's getting worse, isn't it?
But we're only about a few days out from the Antler River. We cross a bridge the first men built. And from there, we can try to find the North Grove. Right, Sylvie?
We're not going north. We're going south, to join Mance and the rest of the Free Folk.
But look...
That was always the plan, Cotter.
I have to go to the North Grove. My family's depending on it.
Your family needs you to wander around in the snow until you get eaten by a direwolf.
Please, Sylvie. He knows what he's doing.
Does he now? Tell me then. How did my brother get that gash in his arm? You dressed his wound up well enough. But why'd he get hurt in the first place?
What does that have to do with the...
Hush, Cotter! I'm asking Fishface here.
Sylvie!
Don't Sylvie me. I want to hear it from him.
Some wildlings, free folk, I mistook Cotter for a crow.
Can't imagine why.
We tried to reason with them and, well, things got out of hand.
Out of hand? From the look of him, he was nearly killed. Point is, you don't belong out here.
Sylvie, I've known Gadded a while now. He may not be one of us, but I trust him.
I've been waiting months for you, Cotter, and when you finally come home, it's with some crow who can barely build a fire. No, we don't need to die for him.
Me neither. Fucking North Grove isn't even real. And if it is, it's probably full of wolves and more wildlings. Fens, probably.
You didn't lose your nerve already, did you?
Finn, will you
Just piss off! Some leader you turned out to be.
You should listen to him. The further north you go, the more likely you'll never come back. It's just not worth it. Once Cotter's fit to travel, we head south. With or without you, Garrod.
Sylvie.
You need to rest. And we'll be wanting more than onions to eat. I won't go far.
Oh, don't be angry, Garrod. This isn't what it looks like. I can explain.
Why'd you even bring me here, Cotter? You said you'd take me to the North Grove.
Sylvie knows these woods better than I do. If anyone can find the North Grove, it's her. And besides, I couldn't just leave her. I won't do that. Not again.
But she's refusing to help. You heard her. Her mind's made up.
She can be stubborn when she wants. But if she's going south, then so am I.
So that's it. I can't head north without a guide.
I go where she goes. I'm sorry, Garrod. Garrod.
Why didn't you just tell me the truth? That you came here to find your sister?
I wanted to, but I didn't think you'd understand. I couldn't risk it. I'm sorry.
You and your sister, you don't look much alike. The white hair and...
I know what you're getting at, so you may as well just say it.
I just wondered.
She was born like that. My mother used to call her Little Moon. The rest of our village thought she was a bad omen. The better of them stayed away from her. The worse? Let's just say I'm glad to be rid of them.
What happened to your village? Did you leave?
Well, not by choice. When Sylvie reached 2 years, they told my mother we weren't welcome anymore. She wasn't welcome. I guess they all hoped she wouldn't survive long enough to get a name. But she's tough, Sylvie. No way she wasn't gonna make it.
Where's your mother now?
Still back at the village for all I know. She tried to send my sister away. Wrapped her up in furs and everything like a good mother would. I left that night when I heard.
Why were they afraid of your sister?
Same reason you southerners call us wildlings. Same reason you put up that wall to keep us out. People are arseholes.
How's your arm feeling?
Decent, I'd say. Why'd you ask? Oh, you mean this one? Yeah, it's shit.
So you really won't take me north?
I want to help you, Garrod, I mean it. But I can't leave her behind. And besides, north of here, I'd be as lost as you.
Wonder if her mother gave her that.
Oh, this is that stuff Cotter was drinking.
Little Moon.
What are you doing over here? There's a perfectly good fire.
I'm not going anywhere near those fucking wildlings.
Oh, come on. Just give them a chance.
I did. And look where it got us.
I'm sorry for getting you into this mess. Really.
Not your fault. I wanted to come. Just didn't know this is how it turned out.
Come on, Finn.
You'll freeze your ass off if you stay here.
Suppose you're right. May as well get warm before I die.
I'll be fine, Garrett. You don't have to keep looking at me like that.
Don't know why you'd want this around.
Sorry.
Never met a crow before. Sorry I almost killed you. Might have done you a favor, though. Plenty of things want to kill a crow up north. Giants, fens, shadow cats and ice spiders. And the White Walkers, of course. A spear sounds nice after all that, doesn't it?
I'm not a crow anymore. I left that life behind me.
Once a crow, always a crow. That's what they say, anyway. Don't frighten our dinner away. Shit.
It's my turn.
You even know how to use that thing. You're not going to shoot me in the leg, are you?
I may do all right.
Just be sure to keep it aimed that way. That's better than making do. You're not a bad shot. You'll do nicely, little one.
Would that be enough?
You ever seen Cotter eat? We'll need another. Come on. Are you nervous? Maybe next time, Garrod. It's not much, but it'll last us. Cooked up with some of those onions you've got, we might even enjoy it. You're not half bad with a bow. Could come in handy. You ever lost anyone, Garrod? Someone you really cared about? Someone you thought you couldn't live without seeing ever again. Do you know what that's like?
I lost everything. My old life. My house. All I ever wanted was to fight for the Foresters.
This house, it was important to you.
They treated me like one of their own.
Cotter and I, we lost everything too. And we nearly lost each other. I didn't think he'd make it back this time. And I won't risk losing him again. Not even for the North Grove.
You know something about it, don't you?
Only what I've heard. But don't get your hopes up. It's not worth it.
So it is real then?
I didn't say that. But it might be. A few years back, one of the Aish River clans set out to find it. They'd heard stories that the cold couldn't touch it, that it's safe even in the dark of winter. So they'd set out, all full of hope, and none of them ever returned.
Maybe they stayed there. Maybe they liked it.
Free folk never stay anywhere. You'd know that if you were...
Garrett! Help!
Cotter!
What the fuck? Look out!
This looks like the place.
This is definitely the place.
So, who are we dealing with exactly?
Pit fighters. Two go in, one comes out, day after day. No rules but kill. Anyone who can survive that is capable of anything. They're crazed savages. But one pit fighter is worth any 10 cell swords. If you can convince them to fight for you. And that's not going to be easy. Don't expect to charm them or reason with them.
I've got enough gold to buy them all.
I'd be careful flaunting it.
Must make you feel pretty good, seeing the masters overthrown.
They're not gone. They're just on their knees. And when they get back to their feet, they'll be more dangerous than ever.
You did what? What the fuck?
Trust me, you don't want to get involved, Asha. Servants and guards of his house. They killed them all.
Why? Some of these must have been slaves too.
Because they felt like it. That's a good enough reason for this lot.
Your friends have been busy.
Let's hope our heads don't end up here. Oh, one last thing. They're not fond of strangers. Or anyone who shows weakness. Or fear. Or really any highborn pricks with lily-white arses like you, little brother.
What are you leading me into, Beska?
Now, I warned you. But don't worry, little brother. I'll protect you.
Well, if it isn't Beska, the fucking basilisk.
We just want to talk to Amaya.
Okay. But not this one hiding behind your skirt. You've got to the count of three to turn around and walk away. One. Two.
Out of my way, fat man.
Or your next meal is my sword.
I like this one. How does he even walk with that pair between his legs? Amaya will decide what to do with you.
Hey! Hey! Whoa! 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 Whoa!
Hello there.
Amaya! Take her!
You must want something pretty bad to risk coming in here. So, out with it. Before I decide not to let you leave.
My name is Asha Forrester, and I've traveled all the way from Westeros.
I'd suggest you go back there. It's not safe here for outsiders.
Amaya, please!
Please what? I had a friend once, the Basilisk, but she died a long time ago.
I earned my freedom!
You walked out on me, on all of us. Fighting side by side, we were goddesses of the pits. But when you're born trash, I guess you can't help going back to the gutter.
You have a problem with her. Deal with me.
So, what is it that you want?
Why shouldn't we rip you to pieces and feed you to a beast?
My patience wears thin.
Enemies murdered his family. He needs men like you to sail with him and take his revenge.
You think we sell swords? We don't fight other people's wars.
We are pit fighters, artists who paint in blood.
That was yesterday. Fighting pits have been closed.
You're all free now. Free to do what you want.
Don't you see that?
Yes, we are free. Why would we follow another?
We don't have masters anymore! Why would we follow anyone ever again?
I'll make you all rich! Your masters, they used you. They made gold from your blood. But I am offering you a chance to earn for yourselves.
Amaya, trust me. He's got enough gold for all of you.
You want to lead pit fighters? You have to earn their respect first.
We don't know who you are until we see you bleed.
You're gonna have to show them you can fight.
All right. Who? Who's the best you've got?
His name is Bloodsong. He's vicious, fearless, and fast.
I've never seen him before.
Take a good look there. He's the man who's going to kill your boy.
And if I beat him, you and your men will join me in my fight.
If you can beat Bloodsong, you'll gain our respect. But no one has ever beat him.
Right. Well, suppose I better get this over with.
So what are you supposed to be?
with your little axe and your pretty blonde beard. I'd sooner bend you over to fuck than fight you.
Thanks for noticing the beard.
Well, come on! Let's see how you die!
If I die in there...
Yeah? You have a dying wish? This ought to be good.
Will you return to Westeros and kill as many White Hills as you can?
No. I'll spend all your gold on the finest of whores.
Hey! I need those!
You'll fight with the weapons we give you.
You all see this cockless Westerosi? He's come to order us to battle, like our masters did. I kill no man because another orders me to. I kill a man because it pleases me! Let me show you how we dance in Meereen. You fight dirty. I like that.
Choose a weapon and try not to die. Only one of you leaves the pit alive. May the best fighter win.
The best would be me.
Here, use this.
Are you ready, Westerosi? This is gonna hurt! Yours will be a beautiful death! Isn't that something you'd like to say? Hear that, boy? We cannot let the crowd go wanting!
I think I can, actually.
For that, you die slow.
That's no weapon.
See if you're still smiling after I break your face.
Surprised you can lift it.
Would it help if I stood still?
Maybe.
Come on, pretty boy. At least try. Look at this terrified boy! He fears his end!
little man!
Do it! Do it! Let him go!
You're stupid, Gen! Your stupid rules! Champion is gone, as are your old masters. You can stay here in the ring with nothing, or you can come with me. I chose you for a reason. I offer you all a new life. You deserve better than this. You deserve more than to die for someone else's entertainment. Fight with me, and you will have glory and gold! If you've got the balls to follow me, we will set sail at dawn. And to those too craven to join me, to hell with you!
Killed!
Your Grace.
You're familiar with my brother's chambers, aren't you? Certainly you've been here before. You looked rather confused when you came in, as if you didn't know where you were.
Yes, Your Grace.
I'd like to think we can be honest with one another. However, you're quite the curiosity, aren't you? You profess to be loyal to the Crown, yet you're not very loyal to Lady Marjorie.
Have I displeased you, Your Grace?
I've heard things. I understand you've been quite busy. Tell me, do you consider yourself an honest, loyal handmaiden? One can never tell with you northern girls, assuming an honest person exists in King's Landing.
I try to be, Your Grace.
I see. I've done my best to keep an open mind about people like you. Yet, Lucan tells me you invited yourself to Tommen's coronation party. How exactly did that happen? It can't have been easy. Or at least it shouldn't have been.
I do what's necessary, Your Grace.
Including using another girl to talk your way in, I'm told. You're not above using people to get what you want. Good. Why would you be so reckless as to risk your neck for what? It all seems rather careless, considering the consequences.
My family is still very much at risk, Your Grace. It was crucial I attend.
Your family. Sometimes that's a convenient lie we tell ourselves. When I suspect your issue with Lord Andros played a part in it. You've been such a busy little handmaiden. I assume Lady Marjorie knew nothing of this.
No, Your Grace.
This wasn't the first time you've hidden the truth from her. You've no qualms about lying to her, have you? Tell me the truth. Your secret is safe with me.
I have in the past, but I won't anymore.
You're a clever girl, aren't you? Perhaps I mistook your northern stubbornness for ignorance, but now I see there's more to you. You're a cunning girl, and perhaps you can help me.
Your Grace?
You're quite friendly with my brother Tyrion. I need you to speak with him before the trial begins. I want to know who he intends to call as a witness on his behalf. Consider it a favor to the Crown, for which we will all be grateful.
I guess I could, Your Grace.
It won't be easy. Tyrion is devious. You'll have to hide your intentions, otherwise he'll tell you nothing. You may prove to be a useful little bird to me, assuming you do as you're told. In return, I'll take care of your problem with Lord Andros.
Thank you, Your Grace.
I never liked the man anyway. And I doubt anyone will miss him.
Think we hired this boat for nothing?
I don't know. That was a rousing speech you gave, little brother. But who knows how much they heard. Ever since you left me to that dragon, I've given a lot of thought to staying here. Leaving you to your Westeros and your foresters.
You have?
I was angry. But you're my family. No matter what, I'd follow you anywhere, little brother. Just try not to get us killed.
Think we'd let you live without us, Westerosi?
They say your homeland is fat and prosperous. An orchard ripe for plucking.
We'll take what we want and kill anyone who stands in our way.
I hired you to kill Whitehills, not to do as you please.
Your war, your way. For now.
I'll show them their beds.
Vesco wasn't exaggerating.
Malcolm, you're here!
And you've found your soldiers.
Ironwrath will be glad of your return.
You came through for them. Just as I knew you would.
What should I tell Roderick?
Tell him what I do.
I do for our house. Daenerys will eventually return to Westeros. If I can, I'd like to help her reclaim the Iron Throne. Imagine what an ally she'd be to House Forrester if she succeeds. Living here has made a better man of you, nephew. Perhaps the same will be true for me.
Thank you, Uncle.
I wouldn't be doing this if it wasn't for you. You've guided me well.
You are your father's son, Asher. For all your differences, he would be proud. I'll send a raven ahead to Ironwrath to let Roderick know you sail for Westeros with, sellswords. My thoughts will be with you in the fight to come. Asher. Iron from ice.
Iron from ice.
Casting off!
Take this. It'll help loosen his tongue. But be careful. He's a tricky little bastard. If he figures out who sent you, he'll tell you nothing. I'll be listening to every word you say.
Oh, I ask for Bronn, they send me a handmaiden. Well, you're here. You might as well come in. Let me guess. Your family is in grave danger, and you've come seeking my help?
Not that I'd be of much use to you.
As you can see, I'm at a bit of a disadvantage.
I brought you a gift.
Wine. You know the way to my heart. And you didn't even have to hide it. Doesn't smell poisoned.
Poisoned?
Cersei would love nothing more than to save herself the trouble of a trial. You don't expect me to drink alone, do you? They never let anyone in to see me. And I've grown tired of talking to myself.
I suppose I'll have just a little.
Ah, true girl of the North. Some things are worth dying for. So, why are you here? It's rather unusual for a handmaiden to visit the Black Cells.
I've been worried about you, Lord Tyrion.
Oh, have you? You may be the only person in all of King's Landing who doesn't want to see my head on a spike. You and Podrick. I have to admit, I've always admired your honesty, but I suspect there's more to you than one might imagine. This is all a ruse, isn't it?
Sorry?
You're coming here. We both know you have an ulterior motive. You've come to set me free. It's the perfect plan. No one would suspect it of you.
You found me out. How did you know?
You can learn a great deal about someone if you're paying attention. So, tell me. Cersei sent you, didn't she? I know I'm not wrong. The truth, Myra.
I don't know what you're talking about. She did no such thing.
The guards have never let anyone in with wine. That was your first mistake. Not that I don't appreciate the gesture. I wish you'd had the courage to tell me the truth. Not that I'm above drinking her wine.
I told you to be careful. He'll twist your words. Stupid girl. You're acting a fool.
Let me handle this. We're not done talking.
You heard the girl. Go.
Imp.
What did my sister expect you would learn?
Who will testify on your behalf?
She's using you, and will continue to do so, until you no longer prove useful.
I know exactly what I'm doing.
Oh, clearly. Which is why you're here, doing her bidding. And what would Lady Marjorie make of your new friendship with my sister? I doubt she'd be pleased. Assuming she doesn't dismiss you immediately.
To be honest, I don't care what Lady Marjorie thinks of me.
I thought you were smarter than that. Without her protection, you're in a very precarious position.
What should I tell Cersei?
You're a clever girl. I'm sure you'll think of something. Although I would suggest you choose your words carefully. Cersei will be far less amused if she catches you in a lie.
I have to give her a list of names.
Tell her I'll call Shagga, son of Dolph from the Mountain Clans. Oh, and Timid, and Chella, and the Scepter who raised me, assuming she's still alive.
Enough of this nonsense! You're wasting my time! Out! Now!
I wish you well, Lady Mira. Be careful who you trust.
Must you leave?
Sorry. Didn't mean to wake you.
You didn't sleep, did you?
Neither did you.
We haven't slept much at all these last few weeks. I hope you don't have any regrets. About this. About us.
My only regret is what happened to your brother. If I'd only...
Please. Let's not talk about Arthur. Not now. What will we do now? Now that we're... what we are?
We'll be married. And no one will be able to keep us apart. Not Griff. Not his father. Not Ramsay Snow.
I was hoping you'd say that.
Roderick? Oh! I'm sorry. I thought you were alone.
Good morning, Talia.
Hello, Elena. Oh... I didn't realize you two were... I mean, I didn't realize she was...
Talia, what's so important?
It's just, this is urgent, Roderick. And...
It's all right. I can go. You two need to speak. I'll see you soon, I hope.
All right, then. I'm listening.
Last night, I couldn't... I was having nightmares. So I...
Go on, Talia.
I went back there. To the grove. And someone was there.
What do you mean?
Look.
This is a report. How many fighting men we have. Where Griff and the White Hill Garrison are being held. It even talks about Elena.
I know. It's everything. I couldn't believe it. If I hadn't seen it with my own eyes...
You said you saw someone. Who?
Someone we trusted.
Talia, I need to know who it was.
He's like family, Roderick. But it doesn't matter. He's a traitor. He endangered our house. You have to deal with him like you would any other man. I'm sure he had his reasons, but no reason is good enough.
Talia, I'll do the right thing. You know me.
I do know you. That's why I need you to promise. Promise me you'll kill him, Roderick. Anyone who would betray us like this deserves to die. I'm asking you, as your sister, make him pay.
I give you my word, Talia. The traitor will get what he deserves. Now, tell me.
Come with me. He's in the Great Hall.
Guards.
Oh, my lord, you scared me after. So you know. I didn't mean for you to learn this way. But it's done now.
You betrayed us, Duncan. After everything my family's done for you.
What I did for your own good. For House Forrester. For your father's legacy.
And what about Garrett? You sent him to the wall for this house.
I sent him there because I had to. Believe me, I didn't want to do any of this.
Why did you do it at all?
Because you're reckless, Roderick. Just as Ethan was. Choosing that warmonger, Roiland, as his sentinel.
Ethan was a boy.
But you're not. And you've been endangering this house since the day you got home. Refusing to kiss Lud's ring, even though you knew he'd retaliate. Pushing this house toward war, despite all common sense. And now... getting Arthur killed!
Enough, Duncan!
You're not a leader. You're a wounded soldier trying to prove he's still a man.
I'm actually trying to save this family. Everything I've done for them. Hate me for it, but it's the bloody truth. And the North Grove, did you tell them about that too?
No, they've never even heard the name. I've kept the secrets that mattered.
The only thing that matters is that you swore an oath to obey me. And you broke it.
I swore to obey your father. He commanded respect. All you command is violence. This house is doomed with you in charge. Oh, and you know it. Hurts me to say that. But I wish you'd never crawled off that corpse cart.
You're a traitor, Duncan! Nothing you say will change that.
I know. What I did was right.
Duncan, how could you?
My lord, Griff's gone. Someone helped him escape. Was this your doing?
Lud was going to ambush you at the exchange. I did it to save your life.
But Ryan, Duncan, I trusted you.
Let's just get this over with.
What do you want me to do with him, my lord?
Roderick, you promised.
Kill me? And I won't be able to help you save Asher. He's in danger, Roderick.
What do you mean? I know Lud's plans. Spare my life, and I'll tell you everything.
Please, Roderick.
Perhaps we should hear him out.
He's only saying that to save himself.
Whatever you decide, temper your anger with wisdom. If not for my sake, then for your family's.
It was the right thing.
What Duncan said.
We have to warn Asher.
We can't, not if he's at sea.
My lord, what do we do?
We'll meet Asher when he lands.
Prepare the horses. We ride for the coast.
Smell that. We're almost there, Beskar. Let's have a look.
Come on, break it up!
Save your lovemaking for below deck.
They listen to you. Barely. But what happens if your lord brother decides he's the one in charge once we're at Ironwrath? Do you expect them to follow his orders? Or will it be you commanding them? They don't know him. A lord sounds an awful lot like a master.
Doesn't matter if Roderick's lord of our house. These are my soldiers to lead.
Huh? You may want to start by telling them your brother's not to be harmed. He hasn't had a chance to win them over like you have.
Point taken.
That's odd. Port's quiet. No guards. Hardly any ships.
Maybe they're all off fighting one of your king's wars.
Could be.
Or, could be we'll have a fight on our hands. I'll let the others know.
Right. Oh, this couldn't be easy, could it?
So, this is Westeros.
Ugly. And small.
Fucking freezing, too.
I said you'd be paid. I never said you'd be warm.
Asher. Thank the gods you've made it back.
I brought you an army, brother. Hope you're ready for a fight.
Lord's got something planned. I don't know what yet. It won't be good.
Been stuck on a boat for weeks. Can use a good fight.
What?
Open!
Asher, no!
It's been a while since I killed any White Elves. I'll hold them off!
Asher
can't.
Is your new lord.
Yes, my lord.
Roderick!
Go! Take as many of them as you can with you!